First John chapter 3. The Bible says in Proverbs 8, it says, he that committed sin is of the devil. For the devil sinned from the beginning, for this purpose the Son of God was manifested that he might destroy the works of the devil. Now this is what the Bible says in verse 9. Listen attentively. It says, whosoever is born of God. That's what I ended 2 weeks ago. That's where I ended. Whosoever is born of God doth not commit sin. For his seed remaineth in him, and he cannot sin because he is born of God. And I said, what does that mean? It means whosoever is born again. You've got to be born again, to be born of God. He says, doth not commit sin. Now there is a controversy concerning that commit there. So a pattern says, whosoever is born of God does not continue in sin. Does not continue in sin. That's how some version puts it. What idea will you get from that type of version? Whosoever is born of God does not continue in sin. That means the idea is that there is still sin in that person. So the person cannot continue to sin. You understand? That means the person can sin, but it's not supposed to continue to sin. And the one that says, whosoever is born of God doth not sin. I did the same thing. I don't know if you understand what I'm saying. Whosoever is born of God doth not commit sin. And whosoever is born of God does not continue in sin. Now I want to understand something here. Now the word, because I tried to look at that word, because I disagree with continue. Continuing in sin is making it mad. Meaning that, well, you see, even though you are born again, you can at times fall into sin, but please don't continue sinning. Don't continue sinning. Don't forget what the Bible says. Paul said in the book of Romans chapter 6, verse 1, he said, shall we continue in sin and say the grace of God will abound? He said, no. How can we, who have been delivered from sin, be found? I'm going to read it for you. Let me read it. Oh, praise the Lord. So I want us to get something here. The Bible says, whosoever is born of God doth not commit sin. If you are born again and your sins have been purged, you don't. And Paul was saying in Romans chapter 6, Romans 6 verse 1, he says, what shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound? God forbid. How shall we that are dead to sin live any longer therein? I'm bringing something there for you to understand. How can we that if you are dead to something? Now, I'm going to look at it. If you are dead to sin, is it possible for that sin to influence you? You are dead to it. You are dead. I mean, how would I put it? Can a delicious bone, a very nice bone or meat, wake up a dead dog? Is it possible? You put it, the dog is dead. You put it in his nose. Will it start to, will it resurrect because of the meat? No way. It's dead. That's how you and I, we are to what? To sin. Shall we continue in sin? Now, this is where I'm going. The Lord just reminded me that I need to clarify this so that you understand what is happening. The Bible said, whosoever is born of God, doth not commit sin. Now, the word commit used in that passage, in Greek it is called poi. Forget about whether poi or whatsoever. What it means is that to make or do. And to stretch it further, according to Strong's Concordance that I looked through, the word can also mean abide, it can also mean agree, it can also mean appoint, can also mean execute, can also mean exercise, fulfill, observe, ordain. It can also mean continue, it can also mean deal. You understand? But in this context, is it being used? There's a suggestion that poi refers to a single act. That means a single word, act. You know what a single act? Does not commit sin. So if it's a single act, it's not a continuous act. Now continue. The one that is common use here is what in the Greek word they call prazo. Forget about the prazo. What that prazo means, it means to do or practice. Now, in this passage we have read, it is poi that is there. not prazo, but the interpretation given to this passage in some other version is prazo, which also means to perform repeatedly, habitually. Can you understand that? What when you say to repeat, and what when you say to perform repeatedly, that's what? Is that not continue? To repeat habitually, is that not continue? Repeat it. But the Bible did not use prazo, but what? Poi. And so, to use continue in that very passage is wrong. Because where we read in Romans chapter 6, verse 1 to 4, when Paul said, what shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin? Now, the continue Paul used there is called epimeno. Forget about all the BB grammar. Epimeno. What it means is that continue. It was continue. So even that word epimeno was not used in that passage. In 1 John chapter 3, verse 9. Prazo was not used because those two words, they mean continue. But one is different from the other. You understand? The other prazo means to do things repeatedly. Repeat it, and so on and so forth. So where I'm going is this. If you are born of God, as far as I'm concerned, the Bible says, whosoever born of God doth not commit sin. Why? Because the sin of the flesh have been pushed away. So if your sin has been pushed away, and as Strong says, and I agree with Strong, that it is a single act. It's a thing that comes that this person will not do it. Single act. I mean, you are born again. Sin is no longer in your dictionary. You don't carry sin all about. Because your sins are what? Pushed. Now, people ask me, excuse me, Pastor, wait. You want to tell me that you don't commit sin? You want to tell me that you have not sinned? You say you are born again. So you want to tell me that you have not sinned. Since you gave your life to Christ, you have not sinned. Because the Bible says, whosoever is born of God doth not commit sin. Let us go on. You understand what I'm saying, my man? Now the second point is this. If you are born again, there must be what? Regeneration. There must be renewal of your life. Regeneration and what? Renewal. In Romans chapter 12. Romans chapter 12. I'm not knowing to finish the message. That's why I don't want to rush. Because I learned that I speak very fast. So bear with me. I'm not going to finish it today. Now I'm going gradually. Romans chapter 12. It says, the second part of verse 2. It says, be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. There must be a renewed mindset. If your sins have been pushed away, you will not commit sin because there is renewal of mind in you. You will not attract sin to yourself. Sin will not attract you because there's the renewal of your mind. 2 Corinthians 5 verse 17. If any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. All things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. Now, sin was old. Sin is regarded as the old thing in your life that has passed away. Now, if sin has passed away, then you cannot sin now. And when I say you cannot sin, this is what I'm talking about. You cannot willingly go into sin. You see, some of us sometimes, because we think faster than our mouth. You understand? Sometimes, our brain moves faster than our mouth. Is that our mouth moves faster than our brain. And so you have not completed before you open your mouth, you have already committed that sin. You have uttered words that are sinful. And when you utter words that are sinful, you don't remain there and justify yourself.